At the end of my last video, I mentioned a hobby that consists of cosplaying as your favourite racing driver in a £10,000 pretend car, more commonly referred to as sim racing, or being a nerd. Despite how modern of a pastime it may seem, force feedback racing wheels have been around since 1997, and nowadays there's so much choice as to what sim racers can waste their money on. If you want to adopt your very own sim racer, a popular place to find one would be the F1 esports stand at a Grand Prix. However, you may already know some sim racers without even realizing. A common giveaway that your friend is a sim racer is if, whenever they're online, they play games with foreign names, such as Assetto Corsa Competizione or Automobilista. You may also be able to tell if they're a sim racer by the fact that they never shut up about it. Once you've adopted your sim racer, you'll need to provide them with some basics to function. These include a fridge full of their favourite energy drink, some gym equipment so they don't need to go outside to exercise, and of course, a sim rig. Now, at this point I should mention that sim racers are not just one specific type of person, and in fact they can be broken down into three categories. These include competitive sim racers, casual sim racers, and nonces. Competitive sim racers get their thrills from close racing and tough competition. Casual sim racers simply enjoy the thrill of being able to drive whatever they want from the comfort of their bedrooms. And nonces, well, you get the idea. In order to communicate properly with your sim racer, you'll need to learn a bit of their vocabulary. A phrase you may hear them say might be, "That was a good race," which generally translates as, "How on earth are you so fast? I've been practicing all week and you're still a second a lap faster than me." Sim racers are often grumpy when something like this happens, so if you hear your sim racer say this phrase, it's probably best to leave them alone for a bit. On the other end of the spectrum, you might hear your sim racer say the phrase, "You almost had me," at the end, which generally implies that they knew they were a second a lap faster than whoever they were racing against, so they deliberately spun to make a race out of it, but still won by a significant margin. After you hear your sim racer say this phrase, you might want to encourage them to take a shower, as they're clearly very sweaty. Similarly, you might want to encourage your sim racer to open the curtains every once in a while, as they spend so much of their life illuminated by their triple monitor setup that they may be lacking a bit of vitamin D. Despite what they may tell you, all sim racers, even the casual ones, hate losing. They will insist to the other people in the lobby that there was something wrong with their equipment before spending yet more money in search of some more speeds, which they probably won't get, by the way. At some point in your time with a sim racer, they will probably offer you a go on their racing simulator. And now, although this may seem like a kind gesture, you must keep in mind that the only reason they're letting you have a go is so that they can beat you. I would still recommend you try out their sim though, as you may find that you enjoy the experience and be able to more emotionally connect with your sim racer over a shared passion. Or more likely, you'll find yourself wondering why they enjoyed this thing because you're slow as fuck. That's not to say that you can't improve if you have some practice, as in the same way that you don't need to be a serial killer to play GTA, you don't need to be a racing driver to sim race. After all, if you did have to be a racing driver, your sim racer would probably not spend their entire life driving pretend cars and just be a racing driver. For a person that spends most of their lives locked away in their bedrooms, sim racers actually have a lot of friends. They just haven't met them in real life yet. As I previously mentioned, sim racers have a slightly different adaptation on the English language to normal people, and as a result you may struggle to understand a conversation between your sim racer and its friends. Some people might argue that sim racing isn't really racing, because there are no consequences to be suffered if you make a mistake. And while there is some merit to that argument, the same argument could be made for running a marathon on a treadmill versus running a marathon against other people in real life. And just like running on a treadmill is still running, sim racing is still racing, just without the fear of breaking your car when you straight line turn one in the Bahrain International Racing Circuit. Dylan. Something to keep in mind while taking care of your sim racer is that you must never, ever distract them while they're racing. If you see them with their headphones on and steering wheel in their hands, please don't pick that exact moment to hoover their room. And yes, this is based on a personal experience. If you take care of your sim racer correctly, then you'll form a strong bond with them, and you will almost certainly become their only real-life friend. With that title comes a great deal of pride, not just for them, but for you as well, because it means you have successfully cared for your sim racer.